It took a long time for anybody to notice. By then, the mutation had spread to millions. The symptoms were nearly imperceptible. Those at risk could not be easily identified by any obvious indicators or patterns. Many were exposed, but few remained unaffected. Who would expect that having better than average health would be a sign of sickness? The common theme that eventually led to the discovery of the mutation was immunity to all illness, bodies that showed no signs of aging, and most importantly, rapid cellular regeneration. In other words, the mutation created immortals. After 5 years, more than 2 billion people were found to have this genetic anomaly. News of being affected was devastating to most. Some attempted suicide. Their bodies regenerated, even after being mutilated, poisoned, asphyxiated, burned, frozen, or pulverized. They worked tirelessly to find a cure, though all efforts were unsuccessful. The immortals grew to feel superior. Many felt that they were chosen ones, gods. This mentality eventually became accepted as fact. Mortals were killed for sport, often publicly executed, and being forced to fight each other to the death. Once hunting down the mortals took too much effort, the immortals decided not to waste any more time eradicating them. Weapons of mass destruction were implemented. The planet was now in nuclear winter. The mortals now extinct. Unable to perish, the immortals walked the barren, once beautiful planet. Unable to unify, they remained scattered, savage, and constantly at war with one another. The Venusians longed to leave their prison cell of a planet. Some groups have been looking at Earth for the next option, a chance for them to start anew and rebuild. We can only hope they never find a way.